Hello, I'm State Representative Kirk Pearson. Thank you for joining me for this edition of my legislative update. This week, the House and Senate rolled out their budgets for transportation and capital projects, also our state operating budget. I'm happy to report our area will receive some long-awaited relief due to a number of projects funded in our transportation budget. Locally, Highway 522 in Monroe will get funds to widen it and make it safer. Also, projects along 530 near Rockport and State Route 9 in Cedar Woolley are on the list to be funded, as is adding turn lanes at Pickle Farm Road near Gold Bar. If you'd like to see a complete list of projects, please call and contact my office. My information will be listed at the end of this brief update. The House proposal for the state capital budget was announced, and it was greatly disappointing to me. With our state operating budget falling short, capital budget writers emptied out $780 million from our capital projects accounts. This budget is used to fund critical state and local infrastructure, build schools, including the public works account that our local governments receive loans from, to upgrade water systems and other items. Now, this money will be used for the state operating budget to pay for government programs and services. In addition, the lottery account set aside for school construction was rated of $182 million. We need to not only ensure promises made with the money in these accounts are kept, but that we have the funds and bonding ability to keep necessary community utilities working properly. The accounts were created from fees charged and were set up to take care of specific issues our communities face. I believe that emptying out these accounts that could be used to build important projects and create jobs is a bad idea. The other budgets we looked at were the House and Senate budgets. Both used $4 billion in federal stimulus money, which we will receive only once to pay for ongoing state expenses. Using the federal stimulus and capital dollars to fill the budget only puts the problem off another 2 years. I would prefer we prioritize spending to meet the needs of our most vulnerable and keep our communities safe. One example in the Senate budget is $538,000 in regular general fund dollars and the $1.6 million of other tax dollars set aside to pay for the setup of a cap and trade tax system on employers. In a time when we are reducing our assistance programs for the most vulnerable, I believe even this relatively small amount of the $30 billion budget could be put to better use in our safety net programs. The House budget cuts $135 million from public safety. The savings are made from letting more felons out early, ending supervision for violent misdemeanors, and cutting community correction officers who monitor offenders in our neighborhoods. I know government needs to slim down and cuts have to be made, but I also believe we could balance the budget in better ways that don't put the public at risk or create new or higher taxes. I'll continue working on solutions during these last 3 weeks of the legislative session, and I'd like to hear your thoughts on the budgets. Thank you for your time today. It's an honor to serve as your local representative, and if I could be of service, please let me know. And I do really appreciate your calls, letters, and emails. And again, if you plan on coming down to Olympia, please give my office a call so I can make arrangements to meet with you. I look forward to telling you what I'm working on in my next update. For now, thanks again for allowing me to serve you.